Council of Architecture of University of Minho. I'd like to thank our invitation by the Scientific College of Design of Oman. We are very honored to be here today with you. I specially greet the Chairman of Board of Directors, Dr. Mohamed Abdel Hasni, and the Dean of the College, Dr. Mona Hamal Ismail, to Mr. Rui Weiner, our greetings as well. This visit reinforced the cooperation initiated by the agreement signed in 2017 between our universities, and hopefully is the first of many. I speak to you about intervention in heritage, both at the building and urban scales, depicting an outgoing project for the rehabilitation of a former historical convent and the community design for 2012 European Capital of Culture, then a study center of the School of University, our school, a studio where we aim to practice research by design. So, let's start with the first case study. Situated on the northern Portugal in Braga, this former monastery, one of the most significant historical monuments in the area, was acquired by the university for the installation of the unit of archaeology and its interpretation center for outside visitors. The study started with an historical retrospective looking for the roots and evolution of the built complex. By the 7th century, it was a mausoleum, still one of the most important mausoleums and Christian landmarks of the period in Iberia, as the gateway of the way to Braga, a former Roman capital. In early modern times, it was significantly enlarged with new buildings, such as a church and a convent that we can still see today. Of course, these days, the assemblage has been integrated in the mass drawing to the outskirts of the city that have grown a lot. And so, it is no longer the isolated Franciscan convent we were found the first. The abandonment of the convent since the 19th century and subsequent interventions have led to this state of despair and ruin you can see by this picture. Such a challenging project required a comprehensive task of teamwork based on a multidisciplinary and collaborative approach, crossing research coming from archaeology and architectural history with an engineering full survey and a deep landscape contextual analysis. Sorry. Architectural survey could only be complete with an array of regional analogies feeding historical and morphological data for the interpretation of the building. For its original and current functional occupation, visual archives proved fundamental for this task. All studies led to a hypothesis of four main stages of evolution, eventually finishing in this very romantic image as a ruin as you can see it today. So, speaking about design options, considering program needs, the project decided not only to rehabilitate the former and ruined convent, but also to add new built structures, taking into consideration previous measures and orientations studied in the earlier stages of this project, as I have shown you before, and you can just see here. At the study center, and overall in our school of architecture, design process takes both drawing and models as a fundamental tool to achieve ideas and concepts. In fact, models helped us to better understand the different components of the building, new additions, and its relations with the ground morphology. So, on the former common area, we try to mix use for the keeping into a live building, in yellow, you can see the part dedicated to the unit of archaeology, while in blue, the visiting circuit allows the visitor to have access to the most novel parts of this ancient monument, which will continue to witness archaeological ongoing research. Furthermore, the new extension comprises laboratorial facilities for the unit. Here, contemporary language was adopted, taking advantage of a lower level of the slope and therefore not disturbing the whole perspective of the built complex. The project assumed all stages and construction details were crucial for coherent intervention of the old structure as well as the new bodies. And the project is ongoing and awaits fieldwork soon. Hopefully, all these studies will see light shortly, inshallah. Moving forward, the new project, before I run out of time, we're also moving forward in scale to an urban proposal already built, and then to another city, Guimarães, also in the northern Portugal. Here, actually, is where our School of Architecture is located. The challenge here was to redesign an important area of public space around the medieval city core on the occasion of Guimarães as the European Capital of Culture in 2012. Again, developed the study center, the approach articulated research and design, starting by interpreting the urban evolution and understanding how these spaces have managed to keep particular stability and coherence through times. The program for this project includes an intervention on a street, a rehabilitation of a square, in fact the most central one in Guimarães, and the redesign of a boulevard, as you can see in the plan. And again, models were key for finding the solutions. Starting by the square called Toral, as you see by the picture, this public space has always been a central pole for the expansion and affirmation of Guimarães urbanity, from marketplace to the 21st century very updated configuration from the mid 19th century, as you can see in the low picture on the right. The new design gave major attention to the pedestrian comfort and took into account important elements of the square, such as the long 18th century facade on the north side, as well as the religious landmarks on the south side. Bottom line, proposed wish to grant this square with a contemporary aspect that regained the capacity of an open public urban space, a place for meeting and reunion. Definitely, one of the essential project decisions was the reintroduction of the Renaissance fountain to its original position, once it had been moved more than a century earlier due to traffic options. This 1500 structure is one of the most evocative pieces of Guimarães' early modern past. Now, with the surrounding bench and its straight geometrical articulation with the opposite side of the square, where a small arboretum composes the design. Moreover, ground design was also a key aspect of the proposal, together with a golden banister which depicts the city's iron tradition for balconies. As the floor sketch, built with reused stones of the former pavement, was developed by the contemporary Portuguese artist Ana Jota, and it displays a portion of Guimarães plan. On the other hand, the boulevard was sought as a wooden artery combining three main reaches. the creation of a more comfortable public space for the inhabitants, the maintenance of a controlled motor circulation and buses canals, plus a more permeable space between the consolidated medieval urban fabric and the growing historical outskirts. This project undertook a very close relation with landscape designers and technical occupations, simultaneously as a permanent dialogue with citizen people wishing to answer the modern needs of a thriving city. Nowadays, this public space ring, which particularly surrounds the dense core enrolled by UNESCO as World Heritage List since 2021, has been fully appropriated by the population in different ways, in different periods of day and in different seasons. Fortunately, it's with pleasure that I witness the full integration in the city's current social dynamic daily, be it every day or festive. I hope this very short presentation was enable a better understanding of the relations between design and the building and urban scales with other disciplines and the sensitiveness that project for heritage context demands. Thank you very much for your attention.